हेलो।
Okay, so I just discussed the steps that we have already done earlier. We started with governing differential equation, and now we are going to deal with a case where eta is greater than equal to 1. So eta is greater than or equal to 1. So S1 and 2, these roots are given as minus eta omega. Now what I am going to do is, I am going to write this bracket as eta square minus 1, because I know eta is greater than 1, so eta square minus 1 is going to be positive. If I have to write that, I will have to assign a minus sign here. So 1 minus eta square now is replaced by minus 1 into eta square minus 1. But what is square root of minus 1? Square root of minus 1 is I. So that I comes out and it gets multiplied by the I already sitting outside. So it becomes I square. I square is minus. So this positive negative sign now will become negative positive, because we are going to multiply it by minus 1. So therefore, S1 or 2 for overdamped system is going to be minus eta omega minus plus omega into square root of eta square minus 1. We know that eta being greater than 1, everything under square root sign is positive, and therefore this square root is real number. Are you with me? What is the next thing that we do? We substitute these two roots and make their linear combination and propose that as a general solution for governing differential equation. So what is the linear combination? U of t is a e raised to s1t plus b e raised to s2t. So ye jo do roots hai, wo yahan pe maine substitute kiya hai, and I have introduced two constants, a and b. Those two constants are to be obtained by satisfying the initial condition. दो इनिशियल कंडीशंस हमारे पास है. कौन से कंडीशंस है? तो एक कंडीशन है u ऑफ 0 इज इक्वल टू u 0, एंड सेकंड कंडीशन है u डॉट ऑफ 0 इज u 0 डॉट. u 0 डॉट एंड u 0 इज ऑलरेडी नोन टू यू. सो नाउ टू अप्लाई द सेकंड बाउंड्री कंडीशन व्हिच इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ u 0 डॉट, आई नीड टू फर्स्ट डिफरेंशिएट दिस कॉम्प्लेक्स लुकिंग इक्वेशन. दैट्स ऑलराइट, आई हैव अप्लाइड चेन रूल ब्ला ब्ला ब्ला, एंड वी गॉट दिस एक्सप्रेशन u डॉट ऑफ t. Are you with me? Now, in both these equations, I am going to put t equal to 0 to apply two boundary conditions that we have. When I substitute t equal to 0 in u of t, I get the first boundary condition, u of 0 equal to u 0 equal to a plus b. You simplify, substitute t equal to 0, you are going to get this equation. And when in second equation of u dot of t, you substitute t equal to 0, we get u 0 dot, and u 0 dot will be this complex looking equation. That's all right. So you have two equations in two unknowns, a and b. You can solve for them. Solve for them, get the values of a and b in terms of known quantities, which are u0 and u0 dot, eta, omega, k, m, whatever. So known quantities may a or b ki value obtain karo. Then consider the same numerical example that we were solving. M is equal to 100 kg, k is equal to 10,000 newton per meter. And then u0 is equal to 0.010 meter. Are you with me? Now take the value of c greater than c star. We know c star we had already obtained, it was 400 kg per second, if I am right. So you have to take the value of c greater than c star. So take it as 500 kg. Everyone can take different value, no issues. So 500, 600, 700 kg per second. Then substitute that value in this solution and plot the Excel. You will again see that u of t never ventures on the negative side. It never becomes negative. It asymptotically approaches zero on time axis. So as t tends to infinity, then u of t tends to zero. That means the mass returns to its mean position at time t equal to zero. Are you with me? Okay. So I leave this part as a homework to you. You have already grasped on what all we have plotted. I have forgotten to share the Excel sheet with you. I will do that in a while. Now we are going to proceed now. Now we have covered quite a lot of ground to solve a numerical problem. So now we are going to take a problem very close to real life problem. It's not a real life problem. Don't write down the problem. Anyway, I'm going to share this board with you. Listen carefully. So we are going to, I'm going to cast the problem here itself. हम यहाँ पे ही प्रॉब्लम कास्ट करेंगे और हम ही सॉल्व करेंगे. इन रियलिटी व्हेन यू गो टू द फील्ड नोबडी इज गोइंग टू गिव यू द रेडीमेड प्रॉब्लम व्हिच यू हैव टू सॉल्व. नो, यू हैव टू कास्ट द प्रॉब्लम ऑन योर ओन बेस्ड ऑन द गिवन रिक्वायरमेंट्स बाय द क्लाइंट. तो हम ही कास्ट करते हैं. एन एलिवेटेड वाटर टैंक ऑफ साइज 4 मीटर बाय 8 मीटर बाय 5 मीटर वेयर 5 मीटर इज द हाइट. सो प्लान डायमेंशंस आर 4 मीटर बाय 8 मीटर. रेक्टेंगुलर वाटर टैंक यू मस्ट हैव लर्नड इट्स डिजाइन इन एडवांस्ड डिजाइन ऑफ कंक्रीट स्ट्रक्चर्स समवेयर इन योर अंडरग्रेजुएट कोर्स. सो 4 मीटर बाय 8 मीटर बाय 5 मीटर आर द इनर डायमेंशंस. सो दिस इज द वॉल्यूम ऑफ वाटर दैट टैंक कैन कैरी. आर यू विद मी? इनर डायमेंशंस है, सेंटर टू सेंटर डायमेंशंस नहीं है. आर यू विद मी? रेस्ट ऑन 4 कॉलम्स ऑफ साइज 300 mm बाय 300 mm एंड 5 मीटर हाइट above the ground level. So you have a rectangular tank which rests on the 4 columns which are 5 meter in height. Then the slab wall and lid. So jo slab hai, the floor slab of that tank, bottom slab, that has a thickness of 250 mm. Walls also have thickness of 250 mm. Everything is in RCC. Water tank hai, so everything is in RCC, and lid also has a thickness of 250 mm. Which is, this is not very practical. Lid is going to have thickness lesser than the wall thickness. We know that. But right now, let us make the problem simple. Let us not go with varying thickness. So 250 mm. And you have been given that all the concrete that is used for columns, walls, and slabs, everything is of M40 grade. Are you with me? So what is M40? What is 40? 40 is the characteristic strength of that characteristic compressive strength of that concrete. What is characteristic strength? It is the strength below which not more than 5% of the test results are expected to fall. That means ye sara structure jis concrete se cast kiya gaya hai, us concrete ke agar aap 100 cubes cast karte ho, the 95% 95 cubes out of that will show you the compressive strength either equal to 40 MPa or greater than 40. Only 5 cubes will have the strength less than 40 MPa at the most. Are you with me? I say it's from the characteristic strength. Okay. Now, why that data has been given? We will see that. Then compute the following. So, kya kya compute karna hai? Hume decide karna hai. Let us try and decide what all we need to calculate. So, naturally, I am interested in the natural frequency of the structure. Do you agree with me? So, I am interested in calculating omega. Are you with me? I am also interested in calculating the value of damped natural frequency of the structure. So I'm interested in omega d. Are you with me? Chalo. Then what else I'm interested in? Let us say I pull this tank towards right by 10 mm or by 20 mm. I want to compute its displacement as a function of time, velocity as a function of time, and acceleration as a function of time. So I need to compute u of t. Are you with me? Then u dot of t and u double dot of t, all the three values I require as a function of time if it is pulled towards right by 10 mm. अब देखो मैं क्या कर रहा हूं. Along shorter and longer direction, longer dimension, longer plan dimension. Are you with me? This is the problem statement that is given to you. Now, how will you solve this problem? Of course, I need to make one statement here. Compute all these things. So, compute A, B, C. A, comma, B, comma, C. When tank is empty, and when tank is full. Are you with me? When tank is empty and full. इसमें और एक स्टेटमेंट में ऐड करने वाला हूं, बट आई विल ऐड दैट स्टेटमेंट एट द एंड ऑफ दिस प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग. एंड दैट स्टेटमेंट इज निगलेक्ट इंटरेक्शन ऑफ वाटर एंड आरसीसी टैंक. सो वी आर गोइंग टू अज्यूम दैट वाटर इज ऑलवेज क्लिंगिंग टू द टैंक. इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू हैव वेव्स जनरेटेड, वेव्स और व्हाटएवर वी कॉल इट, ऐसा कुछ नहीं. सो देयरफॉर वी आर गोइंग टू कंसीडर वाटर एज इनफाइनाइटली स्टिफ मास. इसका मीनिंग क्या है, ऐसे क्यों करना चाहिए, वो हम बाद में देखेंगे. दैट्स व्हाई आई सेड दिस प्रॉब्लम इज क्लोज टू रियल लाइफ बट इट इज नॉट एग्जैक्टली द रियल लाइफ प्रॉब्लम. कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी विल इंक्रीज एज यू गो क्लोजर एंड क्लोजर टू रियल लाइफ प्रॉब्लम. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डू दिस वेयर वी अज्यूम दैट वाटर इज एज इफ इट इज हार्ड एंड कॉन्क्रीट. सो इट इज जस्ट गोइंग टू कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टू मास. दैट्स वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू अज्यूम. आई विल मेंशन दैट स्टेटमेंट एट द एंड ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज. सो सोल्यूशन, सो पहले क्या करना चाहिए, for what do you think, what is the first thing that you need to do? Yes, so the very first thing that we are going to do is to calculate mass in two cases, when tank is empty and when tank is full. Now I am going to draw a schematic of this. Let us say these are the columns, two columns, iske piche bhi do columns hai. Are you with me? And you have a tank here. Are you with me? This is the tank. On top there is a lid, and we assume that in both the cases, whether it is full or whether the tank is empty, the lid is closed. So lid is in place. ऐसे हम assume करने वाले. Now, what is this height? This height is given as 5 meter. Are you with me? Then what is the height of tank? कितना दिया है? 5 meter is the inside dimension. So 5 plus 0.25. प्लस 0.25. सो क्या करना पड़ेगा, 5 plus 5. सो दिस टोटल हाइट इज गोइंग टू बी 5.5 meter. डू यू एग्री विद मी? दिस इज द हाइट. नाउ कैलकुलेशन ऑफ मास. तो सबसे पहले लेट अस कैलकुलेट द मास ऑफ वाटर फॉर द केस व्हेन इट इज फुल. So if this tank needs to be full, what is the volume of water that needs to be there? It is volume of inner dimension, volume of the tank, hai na. So let us calculate mass of water. Chalo quickly, kitna hai bolo? 4/8 × 5 is the volume, hai na. 4 × 5 × 8. What is the density of water? At this stage, should it be given to you? You should know it. It is 1000 kg/m³. So this multiplied by 1000, this mass will turn out to be, this is in kg/m³. And this volume, mind you, I have written it in m³. Be very careful about the units, otherwise you are going to make mistakes. So 4 × 5 = 20, 28 = 160, 160,000 kg. Are you with me? Is the mass of water? Are you with me? Kg. ये हो गया mass of water. What else does possess mass? सो कॉन्क्रीट के वॉल्स को भी मास रहने वाला है एंड यू आर गोइंग टू हैव द मास फॉर कॉन्क्रीट स्लैब लिड एंड कॉलम्स एवरीथिंग. सो लेट मी फर्स्ट कैलकुलेट द मास ऑफ स्लैब एंड लिड. आर यू विद मी? सो व्हाट इज द वॉल्यूम? 0.25 इज द थिकनेस. हैप्पी? मल्टीप्लाइड बाय इनसाइड डायमेंशंस are given as 4/5. So what are the outer dimensions? 4.5 and 5.5. So it is going to be 4.5 × 5.5. Pardon? अच्छा 8 दिया है क्या? ओके 8.5, आर यू विद मी? सो 4.5 इनटू 8.5 इनटू 0.25 इज द वॉल्यूम एंड दिस मल्टीप्लाइड बाय टू नंबर्स. व्हाई टू नंबर्स? बिकॉज यू हैव स्लैब एंड यू हैव लिड. तो दोनों का मास कैलकुलेट करना है एक साथ. सो ट्वाइस दिस मल्टीप्लाइड बाय व्हाट इज द डेंसिटी, व्हाट इज द यूनिट वेट ऑफ कंक्रीट? 25 किलो न्यूटन पर मीटर. सो 25 किलो न्यूटन पर मीटर क्यूब, तो 25 इंटू 1000 न्यूटन पर मीटर क्यूब. डू यू एग्री विद मी? एंड हाउ डू आई कन्वर्ट न्यूटन टू केजी? बाय डिवाइडिंग इट बाय 9.8. आर यू विद मी? सो ये किसमें है? किलो न्यूटन पर मीटर क्यूब. सो व्हेन आई मल्टीप्लाई इट बाय 1000 इट बिकम्स इन न्यूटन पर मीटर क्यूब, एंड व्हेन आई डिवाइड इट बाय 9.81 इट बिकम्स इन केजी पर मीटर क्यूब. समझ में आ रहा? Would be very clear. So tell me what is the answer. How many kgs? 48.5 kg. It's all right. This is the mass of slab and tube. Now let us calculate the mass of walls. Mass of walls. Okay. Can you tell me the perimeter of the wall? Perimeter multiplied by height of the wall multiplied by the thickness. समझ में आ रहा है? So I need to find out now center to center distance. Perimeter अगर wall का चाहिए तो मुझे center to center distance करना निकालना पड़ेगा. So what is the center to center distance? 4.25 into 8.25. 4.25 plus 8.25 into 2 is the perimeter of the wall. Center line का जो perimeter है wall के वो इतना है. Do you agree with me? चलो, I will not go in much details of this. ये सब आपने RCC में सब किया है. I assume that it is, you know that. 4.25 plus 8.25. Are you with me? ये हो गया एक शॉर्ट वॉल और एक लॉन्ग वॉल, इनके सेंटर टू सेंटर डिस्टेंसेस का एडिशन. सेंटर टू सेंटर सेंटर से लेके जो लेंथ है, सेंटर लाइन के अलॉन्ग जो लेंथ है उसका एडिशन. और ऐसे कितने वॉल्स है? शॉर्ट वॉल दो है, लॉन्ग वॉल दो है. सो आई विल हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई इट बाय 2. व्हाट इज द हाइट? नाउ कंसीडर दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंसीडर द लिड थिकनेस एंड स्लैब थिकनेस. So now you have to only consider the inner height, that is 5. Are you with me? So this multiplied by 5, multiplied by thickness 0.25. This multiplied by 25 into 1000. Are you with me? Divided by 9.81. So can you tell me how much is the mass of the wall? Seven nine six three eight point one kg. Are you with me? Now I am going to calculate the mass of columns. Are you with me? So let us calculate the mass of columns. Why I said that this is close to real life problem? Because beam bhi to rahega. Are you with me? So first of all, you are going to have beam, then beam is going to transfer the load on columns. But I am not going into that intricacies. I am just showing you the procedure. If there is a beam, you have to consider mass of beam as well. There may be a staging beam as well. Staging beam ka matlab pata hai aapko? When the water tank is at considerable height from the ground, the columns may buckle. So, कॉलम को बकल ना होने के लिए एक पर्टिकुलर इंटरवल पे हम टाई बीम्स देते हैं. वो जो बीम्स है उनको स्टेजिंग, इसको स्टेजिंग बोला है. वो सब हो सकता है. सो द रियल लाइफ प्रॉब्लम कैन हैव ऑल दोस कॉम्प्लेक्सिटीज, बट इन प्रिंसिपल द स्टेप्स दैट वी आर फॉलोइंग हियर आर नॉट गोइंग टू गेट चेंज. यू हैव टू कंसीडर ऑल दोस कॉम्प्लेक्सिटीज व्हाइल कैलकुलेटिंग एवरीथिंग. आर यू विद मी? सो लेट अस टेक द मास ऑफ कॉलम. तो मास ऑफ कॉलम कितने नंबर ऑफ कॉलम्स है? फोर. व्हाट इज द क्रॉस सेक्शनल डायमेंशन? 0.3 by 0.3. एंड व्हाट इज द हाइट ऑफ कॉलम? इट इज 5 मीटर फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड. सो दिस मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 5 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 25 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 1000 आर यू विद मी डिवाइडेड बाय 9.81. सो टेल मी हाउ मच इज दिस? फोर फोर फाइव केजी. आर यू विद मी? सो नाउ कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट इज द मास ऑफ एम्प्टी टैंक? मास ऑफ एम्प्टी टैंक wait, we will answer this question in a while, and then we have to also consider mass of full tank. Before we answer this question, now tell me, in the context of the problems that we have learned, we said that mass element doesn't have stiffness and damping, and stiffening element doesn't have mass and damping. Ye humne bola tha ki nahi? Now tell me, where should I consider this mass to be located? ये जो सारे मास हमने कैलकुलेट किए, क्या वो एक ही जगह पे लोकेटेड है? No. If you look at mass of the lead, it is located at its center of gravity. It can be idealized to be located at its center of gravity, which is at distance 5 plus 5.5. Are you with me? Somewhere here and there, but is इतने distance पे. The mass of the walls is distributed all along the height of 5.5 meter. Are you with me? Then the mass of the slab is at level of 5 meter approximately, and the mass of the water again is distributed over 5.5 meter. Do you agree with me? And mass of column is distributed about the all along bottom 5 meter. So where should I consider this mass to be acting from the ground if I have to consider it as a lumped mass? Ab hum concept samjhenge jisko bolata hai lumped mass. So if I have to idealize this system as the problem that we did solve, to mujhe ye mass kahan na kahan to ek jagah pe lump karna. I will have to idealize that this mass has been lumped at some location. Are you with me? There are various approaches of doing that. We will stick to the simplest of option of all that, and that is, we will assume the entire mass to be lumped at the floor level, 5 meter pe jo level hai वहां पे ही हम सारा का सारा मास लंप है, ऐसे अज्यूम कर लें. व्हाई? बिकॉज़ द एलिमेंट्स दैट प्रोवाइड स्टिफनेस, कौन से एलिमेंट्स है? अगर मैं इसको लैटरली डिस्प्लेस करता हूं तो किसके वजह से स्टिफनेस मिल रहा है स्ट्रक्चर को? कॉलम्स के वजह से. द कॉलम्स सीज टू एग्जिस्ट एट द लेवल ऑफ 5 मीटर. सो आई आइडियलाइज दैट एंटायर मास हैज बीन लोकेटेड एट द लेवल ऑफ 5 मीटर. द ऑब्वियसली इट इज नॉट करेक्ट आइडियलाइजेशन. दैट्स व्हाई आई सेड वी आर सॉल्विंग दिस प्रॉब्लम in the simplest possible way. This solution is no way close to reality, but all the concepts that we are, all the flow that we are following here is going to remain same. Complexities baad mein hum dekhenge kaise isko real life ke close leke jayenge solution, wo baad mein dekhenge. But at this point of time in our course, I will say that the stiff elements that provide stiffness, they cease to exist at the level of 5 meter above the ground. So I will idealize the entire mass to be lumped at 5 meters above the ground. Are you with me? So ye sara mass. Ab is mass mein you can see that the mass of the column is very close, some up to 2.5 meter is close to the ground surface. To hum kaise karenge? Jo substitute frame method mein jo assumption kiya tha. Do you remember approximate methods of analysis of various frames? Portal frame method tha, then you had cantilever method, then you had substitute frame method. So substitute frame method mein column hum kahan tak ke consider karte the? Half the length of the column. Ye suppose if you are considering this this level, then is beam ke upar half the length of the column and half the length of the column below, aise hum consider. We will stick to that idealization. So in the mass that I calculated to be lumped at the level of 5 meter above the ground, I will consider only half mass of the columns, upper wala half portion. Remaining half portion is transferred to the ground. It is not going to vibrate. That's what I will assume. Are you with me? So sab approximations abhi chal rahe hai. The commercial finite element software does none of these approximations. But then it requires a code to solve the problem. If you don't make the assumptions, you will not be able to solve this problem in this lifetime. Are you with me? So therefore, we start with some assumptions. Wo assumptions kitne valid hai, nahi hai, wo aap baad mein dekhenge. So right now, what are the assumptions that we are making? We are making the assumption that the entire mass of the system is lumped at 5 meter above the ground on the top of columns. Are you with me? At the level of bottom slab. And we also make an idealization that column ka half mass will be considered to be lumped at that level itself. Are you with me? So now, can you tell me what is the mass of empty tank now? It will incorporate now all the masses. So, kon kon se mass? It is going to have the mass of lid and slab. So that is 487385. Kitna hai? 487. Kya tha? 38.5. Are you with me? Plus, it is going to have the mass of walls. Naturally, तो वो कितना है 79638.1 and it is also going to have the half mass of columns, so it is going to be plus 4587.1. So अब मैं जब बोलता हूँ कि I am not going to give you notes, by that what I mean is this, I am not going to write the reason why I have considered it as a half mass. But in your notebook, you should make a star and you should make the reason clear. घर जाने के बाद वहाँ star का आप explanation लिख लो आज class में. So such things I am not going to write it here, but I have explained it in the class. Now can you tell me what is the mass? Total mass? 1307.0.1 kg. Now, just to have a grasp of some numbers, I am going to ask you to find out how much percentage of this total mass is the mass of columns. Matlab, pure columns, 4587.1 divided by 1306.70.1 into 100. Ye kitna hai? 4587.1 divided by 1306.70.1 multiplied by 100. 3.5%. Do you understand? So column ka mass aap half consider karte ho, kitna consider karte ho, uske upar zyada system mein error introduce nahi hone wala. Because it is less than 5% of the total mass or even of empty tank. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Now if you consider that to be full tank, then this percentage of mass of column with reference to total mass is even going to be less. कौन से पैरामीटर का सेंसिटिविटी कितना है ये समझना ये इंजीनियरिंग है. अदरवाइज यू विल बी साइंटिस्ट. अगर आप 7 डिजिट तक नंबर लिखते जाओगे यू विल बी साइंटिस्ट. बट वी नो हाउ मेनी सिग्निफिकेंट डिजिट्स आफ्टर द डेसिमल आर इंपॉर्टेंट. दैट्स इंजीनियरिंग. आर यू विद मी? सो चलो, सो वह मास ऑफ फुल टैंक कितना आएगा? सो एम्प्टी टैंक का मास तो है 1306.70.1. आर यू विद मी? प्लस इसमें ऐड क्या होगा? We are going to add the mass of water. So what is the mass of water? Tremendous. It is 160,000 kg. 160,000 kg. So can you add these two and tell me the number? 290.670.1 kg. Happy? Now just look at the conditions when you are considering the tank to be empty. At that time, its mass is almost half. No, not almost half, even lesser than half. Are you with me? When it is compared to when the mass is full, when the tank is full. Are you with me? So ab zara yahan pe dhyan do, all the things that we are talking about, natural frequency of the system, will it be dependent on mass? Of course. We know that it is square root of k by m. And the mass of the system of such structure itself is in question. When earthquake occurs, whether the tank was full, whether it was half, whether it was empty, the response of the system will be governed by the presence of amount of water in the tank. Do you agree with me? So such problems are complicated to analyze. So we have to consider the worst possible combinations. We will correlate this with, imagine that the earthquake occurs now, the class is full. So the mass of the system is to its fullest possible extent. All the classes are full, let us assume. But if the earthquake occurs during the night time, classes are empty. So mass is different. So at what, in what conditions does the earthquake occur? Uske upar bhi to system ka response and this destructive power of earthquake depend karega. Do you agree with me? So what are the coral provisions? Now, of course, we have to collect this, connect this theory with the codes. What does force say? How much of live load should you consider when you are designing a structure for seismic load? So it, there are various combinations. In one of the combinations, it says that you have to consider 0.5 times the live load. Are you with me? So those are some factor of partial safety factors are there. They have some connection with all these conceptual understanding. The response of the system itself is dependent on mass. So how much mass would you consider, such as mass of water, live load? You kitna consider karoge when you are analyzing the structure for seismic load is important. This is the first part. So solution of problem is one thing, but allied jo concepts rehte hai, uske through bhi aapko dekhna hai. Then only you will get the expertise in structural dynamics. Now let us go ahead. This is, we have calculated the mass. What should we do next? Now why did you calculate mass? क्योंकि हमने प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व किया है जिसमें हमारा इक्वेशन mu डबल डॉट प्लस के यू है प्लस सी यू डॉट इक्वल टू सम ब्ला ब्ला, ये हमारा इक्वेशन है. सो जो प्रॉब्लम, जो इक्वेशन हमने सॉल्व किया है उसके साथ इसका कुछ तो कनेक्शन होगा, इसीलिए ये प्रॉब्लम यहाँ पे लिया है, ये हमें पता है, इसलिए हमने मास कैलकुलेट. नाउ व्हाट व्हाट शुड यू कैलकुलेट नेक्स्ट? फिर डायरेक्ट फ्रीक्वेंसी को कैसे जाएंगे? लुक एट द इक्वेशन mu डबल डॉट प्लस cu dot plus k, c or k, ye next in line. Do you agree with me? So next in line is we are going to calculate stiffness. Are you with me? So we are going to calculate stiffness of the system. Now tell me, what kind of stiffness are you talking about? There are various stiffnesses. For example, if I press this stand down and release it, it is going to exhibit the vibration. Jaise hum spring ko press karke release karte hai, it is going to exhibit the vibration. And you see, why say, if I press this tank from top to down like this and release it, it is going to vibrate along the axial direction of columns. So, us case mein hume kaun sa stiffness chahiye? We need to have axial stiffness. Are you with me? Now, I can always twist this tank in the plan. Matlab, is tank ka agar maine plan nikala, to ye aisa wala hai. Are you with me? This is the plan. Happy? The wall thickness is 250 mm and inner dimensions are 4 meter by 8 meter, whatever it is. I can always twist this tank and release it. It is going to exhibit vibrations in torsional mode. Do you agree with me? So in that case, I will be interested in its torsional stiffness, axial stiffness, torsional stiffness. So which kind of stiffness are you talking now? So when earthquake occurs, typically, we are not interested in vertical component of the earthquake. We are interested in lateral component of the earthquake. So we are now talking about the lateral stiffness of the structure. That lateral stiffness or that lateral force is going to put columns in bending. Do you agree with me? Jaise main aap ye mass yahan pe hai, so you can imagine when earthquake occurs, the inertial force will be experienced somewhere here, and this force is going to put columns in bending. So therefore, the stiffness of the system is in fact the lateral stiffness, first thing. And lateral stiffness of the system is on account of what? It is on account of flexural stiffness of columns. Do you agree with me? Columns ka jo flexural stiffness hai, uske wajah se system ko lateral stiffness mil raha hai. We assume, we make one more assumption here, that these walls of the structure, they have zero flexural rigidity, they have zero flexural stiffness. So the entire stiffness of the structure or the entire resistance to lateral load is on account of bending of columns. Samajh mein aa raha hai? And then how do I calculate that stiffness? So now structural analysis comes to your rescue. I can idealize the column to be fixed here. I can idealize the column to be fixed at the bottom of this map. Are you with me? So if I consider one column, it is fixed at base and it is fixed at top. And now if I have to move it laterally by amount delta, are you with me? The question that I am going to ask you is, how much force should I apply at the top? Is column ko mujhe delta se laterally leke jana hai. So what is the force that I should apply here? So let us understand this question and answer this question in a stepwise manner. अगर मुझे उसको राइट में डेल्टा अमाउंट से लेके जाना है तो नेचुरली आई हैव टू अप्लाई फोर्स टुवर्ड्स राइट, लेफ्ट को तो अप्लाई नहीं कर सकते. आर यू विद मी? सो देयरफॉर आई हैव शोन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द फोर्स. व्हाट इज द कॉन्सिक्वेंस? कॉन्सिक्वेंस ऑफ दिस फोर्स व्हिच इज अप्लाइड एट राइट इज द रिएक्शन दैट गेट्स डेवलप्ड एट द बॉटम टुवर्ड्स लेफ्ट. आर यू विद मी? एंड दिस टू फोर्सेस मस्ट बी इक्वल फॉर द इक्विलिब्रियम. Are you with me? So, agar laterally mujhe delta se top ko displace karna hai towards right, consequence, equal and opposite reaction will be generated at the base. Happy? Now, these two forces are equal and opposite, their lines of actions are parallel and they are separated by distance L, length of the column. Do you agree with me? So, what do they constitute? They constitute couple. Are you with me? Moment of couple of forces. So, moment of couple of forces कितना होगा? तो इन दोनों forces का जो magnitude है, if I call this as F, this also will be F. So, F into L is going to be the couple moment. Do you agree with me? And what is the direction of this couple moment? Clockwise or anti-clockwise? In this particular case, it is clockwise. Consequence, at fixed support, anti-clockwise moments must get developed. Do you agree with me? And we know that this anti-clockwise moments, they are equal in magnitude. And what is the magnitude? Tell me. Structural analysis. See, we have proved by flexibility method that if you have to have delta towards right for the column which is fixed, then this must be equal to 6 EI delta upon L square. Are you with me? Agar sab pata nahi hai to revise. This is also 6 EI delta upon L square. Happy? So what is the total moment that is generated? 12 EI delta upon L square. That must be equal to F into L. So what must be F? It must be 12 EI delta upon L cube. Samajh mein aa raha hai? So therefore, I must have this is equal to 12 EI delta by L cube. And similarly, I need to apply a force of magnitude 12 EI delta upon L cube. So to have this delta in first place, I will have to apply a force of magnitude 12 EI delta upon L cube. Are you with me? What is EI? EI is nothing but flexural rigidity. What is I? Moment of inertia. It is not mass moment of inertia. It is moment of inertia of a cross section about the axis of bending of a column. Are you with me? So what is that 12 EI delta upon L cube is the amount of force that I must apply at the top of one column in order to move that column by amount delta. What is stiffness? It is action required to cause unit corresponding deformation. So if delta is equal to 1, what is the corresponding action? Force. How much force would I require? 12 EI upon L cube. Do you agree with me? So what is the stiffness? Stiffness is for one column. If I want to move it laterally by unit amount, I require a force equal to 12 EI upon L cube. That itself is its flexural stiffness. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Aise kitne columns hain? Char. So if I have to move the tank towards right by 1 mm or 1 unit, how much force should I apply? 48 EI. Upon L cube, where L is the length of column. We assume that the columns have same length. If the tank is on slope, each column will have different length. Then you will have to do summation 12 EI LI cube upon 12 EI upon LI cube summation I running from 1 to 4. Agar har ek column ka length alag hai, toh aise karna. But as the length of column is given same here, therefore, what is the stiffness? Stiffness is lateral stiffness of the structure, but it is also the flexural stiffness of columns. Do you agree with me? Flexural of columns. And how much is that? Tell me. It is 48 E I upon L cube. चलो स्टिफनेस का यूनिट क्या होना चाहिए? न्यूटन पर मीटर. वी आर डीलिंग विद एसआई सिस्टम, तो ये हमें किसमें कैलकुलेट करना है? न्यूटन पर मीटर में कैलकुलेट करना. आर यू विद मी? सो आई एम सेइंग के ऑफ दिस सिस्टम इज इक्वल टू 48 ईआई अपॉन एल क्यूब. 48 कहां से आया? 12 ईआई अपॉन एल क्यूब फॉर वन कॉलम. चार कॉलम के लिए 48 ईआई अपॉन एल क्यूब. नाउ डू आई नो आई? आई पता है क्या? 300 by 300, इसीलिए कॉलम स्क्वायर क्रॉस सेक्शन का लिया. सो एज द कॉलम इज ऑफ स्क्वायर क्रॉस सेक्शन, इफ दिस इज द न्यूट्रल एक्सिस, देन बी इज आल्सो 300 एंड डी इज आल्सो 300. सो व्हाट इज द व्हाट इज आई? बी डी क्यूब बाय 12. सो कौन सा भी बी लो, बिकॉज द कॉलम इज स्क्वायर इन नेचर. सो देयरफॉर 300 इनटू 300 क्यूब डिवाइडेड बाय 12. ये किसमें आएगा? mm raised to 4. So if I were to convert it into meter raised to 4, क्या करना पड़ेगा? 10 power minus 12. Are you with me? If I multiply it by 10 power minus 12, that is the conversion from mm raised to 4 to meter. mm to meter का conversion क्या है? 10 power minus 3. 10 power minus 3 raised to 4. मतलब क्या हुआ? 10 पावर माइनस 12. आर यू विद मी? सो दैट इज द कन्वर्जन ऑफ mm रेस टू 4, बट दिस क्वांटिटी विल बी इन, व्हेन आई मल्टीप्लाई इट विल बी इन मीटर रेस टू 4. एंड दैट्स व्हाट आई वांट, बिकॉज़ आई एम डीलिंग विद द यूनिट ऑफ न्यूटन एंड मीटर. कैन यू टेल मी दिस अमाउंट? नो नो, डोंट कैलकुलेट दिस सेपरेटली. वेट, नाउ इफ आई, व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ बी? टेल मी. 2.1 क्या है? 2.1 पार्डन, स्टील का स्ट्रक्चर है क्या? अरे किसका स्ट्रक्चर है ये? दिस इज आरसीसी स्ट्रक्चर. सो फॉर आरसीसी स्ट्रक्चर हाउ डू यू कैलकुलेट ई? 5000 रूट एफ सी. शुड इट बी नाउ टोल्ड टू यू? नो, इट इज देयर इन आईएस 456. इन एब्सेंस ऑफ एनी अदर एक्सपेरिमेंटल डेटा और एनी अदर डेटा गिवन इन द प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट, we consider short term elastic modulus of concrete as 5000 root fc. That's why that m40 is given. Are you with me? So what is the value of e? 5000 root fck. Be very careful while you use this expression. Why? Because this is not dimensionally homogeneous. Zara dekho left hand side mein, what is the unit of e? E ka unit kya hai? Stress ka unit, because stress upon strain is e. Are you with me? So stress का जो unit है वो रहने वाला है. So it is going to be newton per mm square, that is MPa. But we want now E in newton per meter square, not in MPa. Are you with me? In this formula, when you use this as 5000, ये FCK का unit क्या है बोलो? Newton per mm square. So right hand side का unit क्या है? Square root of newton per mm square. So it is square root newton by mm. लेफ्ट हैंड साइड का क्वांटिटी और राइट हैंड साइड के क्वांटिटी दोनों का यूनिट ही सेम नहीं है. सो देयरफॉर ये जो कांस्टेंट है, दैट कांस्टेंट विल डिपेंड अपॉन द सिस्टम ऑफ यूनिट्स दैट यू यूज. इट इज डायमेंशनली नॉन होमोजेनियस इक्वेशन. देयरफॉर आई स्कोर स्पेसिफिकली सेज यू विल गेट ई इन न्यूटन पर एमएम स्क्वायर इफ यू सब्स्टिट्यूट एफसीके इन न्यूटन पर एमएम स्क्वायर. आर यू विद मी? सो ये 5000 जो कांस्टेंट है, दैट विल चेंज if you want to get in E in newton per meter square. Dimensionally non-homogeneous equations mein you have to be very careful about the system of units in which the constants are specified. So therefore, what is value of E in terms of MPa? Bolo 5000 root 40 hai na, to kitna aata hai bolo? 3162.7. This is in newton per mm square. I want it in newton per meter square. So mm to meter conversion kya hai? 10 power minus 3. So mm square to meter square, 10 power minus 6. And that 10 power minus 6 is in numerator, in denominator. So it goes on the numerator and becomes multiplication by 10 power 6. Are you with me? So value of E in Newton per meter square will be equal to 31622.7 multiplied by 10 power 6 Newton per meter square. Be very careful about the system of units. Otherwise, किसी आंसर का कोई मीनिंग नहीं होगा. Now, so 48 EI upon L cube. What is the value of L? L is already given to you. That is 5 meter. What is the length of column? 5 meter. So now can we calculate K easily? What is the value of K? Tell me now. 48 into E into I. What is the value of E? 31622.7. 31622.7 into 10 power 6. ये कौन से यूनिट में है? न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर. हैप्पी डिवाइडेड बाय लेंथ की वैल्यू किस में है? मीटर में है. आर यू विद मी? मल्टीप्लाइड बाय आई. आई की वैल्यू किस में हम लिखेंगे? मीटर रेस टू 4. जरा मल्टीप्लीकेशन करो. न्यूटन अपॉन मीटर स्क्वायर इंटू मीटर रेस टू 4 क्या होता है? पार्डन, न्यूटन मीटर स्क्वायर. तो क्या गड़बड़ है? नो वेट, यहाँ पे देखो 12 EI डेल्टा अपॉन एल क्यूब. तो 12 ई का यूनिट क्या है बोलो? न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर. व्हाट इज द यूनिट ऑफ आई? मीटर रेस टू 4. सो व्हाट इज द यूनिट ऑफ दिस? न्यूटन अपॉन मीटर स्क्वायर into and what is the unit of length? Meter. So yahan pe meter cube hoga. Are you with me? So Newton upon meter square multiplied by meter raised to 4 by meter cube, hai na? To unit kya hua bolo? Yahan pe meter square rahega, then this with Newton per meter rahega, and we have multiplied it by delta, to wo Newton mein aata hai. Are you with me? But that delta is missing here, क्योंकि हम उसको unit जैसा substitute करते हैं. So therefore, even if you don't get the matching of dimensions, it's okay. This k is in newton per meter, that's for sure. That delta was well, वो हमने one लिखा, लेकिन उसका unit नहीं था. You have to all consider this multiplied by one, then write its unit, then you will get everything right. So now, that's fine. So what is the value of I? Tell me in meter raised to 4. कितना है? कहा गया वो? यस, 300 इंटू 300 क्यूब, दैट इज 300 रेस टू 4 बाय 12. आर यू विद मी? मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 10 टू द पावर माइनस 12. सो हैव वी कंसीडर्ड एवरीथिंग इन के? यस. सो कैन यू टेल मी द वैल्यू ऑफ के इन न्यूटन पर मीटर नाउ? ये क्यूब है ना, सो ये होगा मीटर क्यूब. इट वर्क्स आउट वेल. न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर इनटू मीटर रेस टू 4, सो दैट बिकम्स न्यूटन मीटर स्क्वायर बट डिवाइडेड बाय मीटर क्यूब. इट्स ऑल राइट. सो इट इज न्यूटन पर मीटर. सो टेल मी द वैल्यू. 8. Into now 10 power 6 है तो मुझे आगे के डिजिट्स भी बताओ. 8.19 6 0 1 2 3 4 5 6. ओके, इंटू 10 पावर 6 न्यूटन पर मीटर. दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ के. आर यू विद मी? सो वी हैव गॉट द वैल्यू ऑफ के, वी हैव गॉट द वैल्यू ऑफ mass m. So now who is, what is the restriction in now finding out the natural frequency? Are you with me? Lekin wo karne se pehle, now what I am going to do is I am going to represent this system in terms of the problem that we have solved. Can I represent that? तो देखो यही सिस्टम को क्या मैं ऐसे दिखा सकता हूं, दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ के. व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ के, अभी अपने कैलकुलेट किया 8.19660 3 into 10 power 6 newton per meter. And what is the value of mass? बोलो मास की वैल्यू क्या है, हमने कैलकुलेट की थी ना. सो व्हेन इट इज एम्प्टी टैंक वी विल नाउ यूज अ कलर कोड. व्हेन इट इज एम्प्टी टैंक वी विल राइट इट इन ब्लू एंड व्हेन इट इज फुल टैंक वी विल राइट इट इन रेड. सो एम्प्टी टैंक के टाइम वैल्यू क्या है, आई विल टेक दीज टू वैल्यूज देयर. This is the value of m when it is empty. Are you with me? And this is the value of m when it is full. These are the two values. Can I represent the system as this one? Yes. And what are we looking at? We are looking at its lateral vibration. So yaha pe jo maine delta bola hai, I have called this displacement as delta. That now here becomes u of t. Are you with me? So I am interested in doing it. U of t. Are you with me? So we will take forward this problem in the next class. What are we going to do now? We are now going to find out natural frequency. Damped natural frequency ke liye damping ke bare mein kuch bolna padega. So we are going to discuss that in next class. And then we are going to solve the last step, last part of it. You are finding u of t for 10 mm displacement towards time. So let us stop here. Please use the same link for attendance.